I've had staff that I've had to fire in the past, and that's something you always have in the back of your mind. What are they going to do?
Right.
So you've got two choices in that regard, and a lot of times the draconian choice is you're out of here right now.
Right.
Because I'm afraid that you might do something like that.
Yeah.
So I've had employees where I've had to do that. I've also had the employees where I know that they wouldn't do that because I know, and I've had to get rid of them for whatever reason, or they decided to leave on their own. And so you give them, you know, time to do that.
Yeah.
And so, but you do have to worry about that.
Sure.
In a law firm particularly, because all of those client files,
right,
that they have to protect, and all the information in that, those client files.
Yeah.
And that's another concern from the cyber security standpoint, is how secure are those client files?
Right.
Can they be hacked? Can that private information be gotten? And the law sure. firms have to worry about that.
Yeah. Wow. So that's an interesting case. So, Eunice, so you're writing these policies for business owners. There's ways that business owners can protect themselves.
Absolutely. Another big risk would be doctors, chiropractors, dentists, because they have to do all this. They have to maintain all this information, this personal information, to deal with the health plans.
Right.
So they know your date of birth, your social security, your address. And every time they talk with you on the phone, you have to confirm this information to them,
mm-hmm.
or they confirm the information with you.
Right.
I've actually had phone calls where they tell me the information, and I'm like, okay, that's not really safe for you to be giving me that information over the phone like that. And if you don't have employees that are really aware of the types of identity theft exposures that are out there,
right,
you could have a real big problem. The other issue that we've been facing recently is the ransomware, where somebody hacks into your computer and they shut down all your computer and they extract all your documents and they demand a ransom, usually starting around $500.
Wow.
To release your documentation. Now, this is $500 is usually for a person. At a consumer level. Now, if it's a big corporation and they hold them ransom, and I believe this happened to Sony a couple of years ago, then we're talking thousands of dollars.
Yeah, I do remember that. I remember that. And it happens all the time. Identity theft, you know, is out there. That's why you see these companies like LifeLock and some of the other, you know, spinoffs of LifeLock. And you have, you know, the identity theft that's out there with, you know, just your identification, your credit report, your credits all jumbled up. That's where we see it in the real estate space, the mortgage space. So, wow, it is a crazy world. There's a lot of opportunity for these thieves and you know, people to hack into computers. Pretty much any computers available to be hacked. It's just how much resources do the bad guys have.
Right. And sometimes using like Starbucks to go and work, which a lot of people do, it's easy to take your laptop and use the Starbucks Wi-Fi. Anybody with less than $100 can get a machine that can track into that Wi-Fi and start hacking all the computers that are connected to that Wi-Fi.
Wow.
So that's another dangerous thing right there.
Yeah.
That many of us do without even thinking about it.
Wow.